Oh, my feet didn't turn into beads. That's a good start. Should have known a herbologist would use devil's snare. Lumos. Lumos. A troll? You can't be serious. think they felt that in London. Mama Duke certainly left behind more than plants. Sarcophagus. This must be Marmaduke. That should reverse the curse. Hopefully. Svantha will be glad to hear that the crest has been returned. I certainly hope it reverses the curse.
Nice to see you, my young friend.
I'm happy to tell you that I returned the crest to Marmaduke's sarcophagus, just as you asked.
I thought as much. I received word from St. Mungo's that my brother's feet are back to normal. No more beats. Oh, I cannot thank you enough. It wasn't too much trouble, I hope.
Well, there was a troll in the tomb.
A troll? Oh dear, I'm so sorry. That's awful. No one has been in that tomb for centuries. But I can't say I'm surprised. Marmaduke seems to have been full of surprises.
Indeed he was.
Well, I suppose I should be going. I'm anxious to see my brother, who must be elated to have his feet back.
Of course, I certainly would be.
William and I are forever in your debt. Thank you again for what you did.
Professor Garlick, a moment of your time?
The plants are resting, so now's as good a time as any.
Apologies, Professor. Perhaps later.
Not to worry. I'll be here if you'd like to talk.
You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented flu powder. Thank you.
I should let Deke know about the newborn Thestral. Hello, Deke. You'll be pleased to know that a little Thestral was born.
How wonderful to have more Thestrals in our world. Such misunderstood beasts.
I'm sorry that we both can see Thestrals, Deke.
Deke is privileged to see such majestic beasts, but sometimes wishes Deke couldn't. Deke is to blame.
What do you mean, to blame?
Years ago, Deke's master ordered Deke to help him capture a phoenix, the rarest of all beasts, that Master had spotted high on a cliff. The phoenix was the most beautiful beast Deke had ever seen. Deke begged Master to leave her be. When Deke hesitated to climb up the cliff as ordered, Deke had to punish himself. As Deke punished himself, Master grew angrier and angrier, and in his frustration cast at the regal bird. Deke suspects the phoenix was protecting eggs when it swooped down in fear and fury. Before Deke could reach him, Master fell from the cliff. Deke stayed on that cliffside for days, punishing himself, before Tobbs found him.
It sounds to me as if your master got what he deserved.
Deke never wanted anyone to get hurt. Not the phoenix, not Tobbs, and not even Master. Deke often wonders what became of that phoenix. Deke feels fortunate to be at Hogwarts now, helping you rescue beasts. Perhaps Deke can make amends for what came before.
Excellent work today. Class dismissed. I take it you're ready to learn your new spell.
I completed your assignment, Professor. I'm ready to learn Bombarda now.
Good. Now, this spell comes with a caveat. It should only be used when necessary. The exploding charm, as you might suspect, can hurt people. Use caution when casting it.
Is this something we should be learning in school?
Better for you to learn it in school, where we can instruct you properly as to its use, Now, you must be precise in your wand movements. We don't want you blowing your hand off. Go ahead. Nice and steady wand movements. Remember, the exploding charm is highly volatile. Well done. Now, let us put it into practice, shall we? Go ahead and try it on the pumpkins.
Bombarda!
Excellent wand work. Cast the spell just like that every time. Assured and in control.
Professor, might I have a moment?
Yes. What is it?
Apologies, Professor. Perhaps later.
Very well.
Alohomora.
do we have here? A demiguise. Mind now, demiguise. Alohomora.
Excellent. You have it well in hand. Thank you.
On another adventure, are we?
You'll never believe what I've learned.
What did you discover in the spellbook we found in the scriptorium?
Salazar Slytherin's spellbook was a little difficult to interpret, but fascinating. Evidently, he encouraged teaching dark magic at Hogwarts. Neither the Imperius Curse nor the Killing Curse was unforgivable during his time. He believed students should be prepared to use dark magic when necessary, not to fear it. That's why we had to use Crucio to gain access to the scriptorium. He didn't want his knowledge shared with anyone who was afraid of the power of dark magic.